It did not take long for the city of Fort Lauderdale to make good on its promise to criminally charge those who violate a new ordinance that effectively outlaws groups from feeding the homeless in public.
On Sunday, the city charged three people, including two ministers and a 90-year-old homeless advocate, and they could face up to 60 days in jail for their so-called crime. Bob Norman has the update.
I fully believe that I am my brother's keeper. Love thy neighbor as thyself.
90-year-old Arnold Abbott prepares hundreds of meals each week for the homeless in the kitchen of the Sanctuary Church.
We serve two entrees at every feeding.
But Abbott's work now has him in trouble with the law.
Why is he being arrested?
Shame on you! Shame on you!
He faces possible jail time and a $500 fine for feeding the homeless after he was charged Sunday with violating a new ordinance that virtually outlaws groups from sharing food with the hungry in the city.
One of the police officers came over and said, "Drop that plate right now." And so I was carrying a weapon.
Also charged was a minister from Coral Springs and Sanctuary Church pastor Dwayne Black.
We believe very strongly that Jesus taught us that we are to feed his sheep.
Mayor Jack Seiler warned arrests were coming.
We enforce the laws here in Fort Lauderdale.
It's man's inhumanity to man.
Back in 1999, Abbott sued the city for banning him from feeding homeless on the beach, a lawsuit he won.
Well, I'm going to have to go to court again to sue the city of Fort Lauderdale, a beautiful city. These are the poorest of the poor. They have nothing. They don't have a roof over their head. And who could turn them away?
Abbott's going to be firing up these stoves again on Wednesday when he's got another food sharing planned for the beach. He says he doesn't want to be arrested, but he's prepared for the possibility. In Fort Lauderdale, I'm Bob Norman. Local 10 News.
Okay, Bob, thanks. And Bob tells us that despite those charges, other groups also say they intend to continue feeding the hungry in Fort Lauderdale despite that new law.